all praise, all thanksgiving, every moment, O God.
Our Father, heaven, holy be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
O sacrament, most holy, the sacrament divine.
O Lord, grace and all thanksgiving, every moment of time.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
O sacrament, most holy, sacrament divine.
All praise and all thanksgiving, every moment.
By his gospel, our Lord and Savior has lighted up for us the way to life and immortality. Lord, you have been good to your servant according to your word. Teach me discernment and knowledge, for I trust in your commands. Though the proud smear me with lies, yet they keep your precepts. Their minds are close to good, but your law is my delight. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Psalm prayer. Lord, teach us goodness, discipline, and wisdom, and these gifts will keep us from becoming hardened by evil, weakened by laziness, or ignorant because of foolishness. Have mercy on me, God, men crush me. They fight me all day long and oppress me. My foes crush me all day long, for many fight proudly against me. All day long they distort my words. All their thoughts is to harm me. They band together in ambush, trap me down and seek my life. This I know, that God is on my side. In God whose word I praise, in the Lord whose word I praise, in God I trust, I shall not fear. What can mortal man do to me? Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Psalm prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, victim for our sins, you trusted in your Father's protection and kept silent when you were tormented. Give us that same confidence, and we will gladly suffer with you and for you, offering the Father our sacrifice of praise, and walking before Him in the light of the living. Have mercy on me, God, have mercy, for in you my soul has taken refuge. In the shadow of your wings I take refuge, till the storms of destruction pass by. May God send His truth and His love. O God, arise above the heavens, may your glory shine on earth. My heart is ready, O God. My heart is ready. I will sing your praise. Awake my soul, awake lyre and harp, I will awake the dawn.
I will thank you, Lord, among the peoples. I will praise you among the nations. For your love reaches to the heavens, and your truth is the skies.
O God, arise above the heavens. May your glory shine on earth. As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Psalm prayer. Lord, send your mercy and your truth to rescue us from the snares of the devil, and we will praise you among the peoples and proclaim you to the nations, happy to be known as companions of your Son. By his gospel, our Lord and Savior has lighted up for us the way to life and immortality.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
At that time Jesus said, "This is how you are to pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And do not subject us to the final test, but deliver us from the evil one." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I invite you, in your meditation, dear brothers, to reflect on what we call the Lord's Prayer as the Lord's vision and mission statement. In the Gospel of Luke, chapter 11, the Lord's Prayer is in the context of a request from the disciples. Lord, teach us to pray, as John taught his disciples to pray. perhaps in prayer, Jesus intended that we rehearse in our minds His vision and mission. What we call the Lord's Prayer is a prayer in two parts, the heaven part and the earth part. It is taken for granted in Israelite faith that heaven and earth have been detached or isolated from each other because of human sin. Heaven becomes something up there and earth becomes down here. And God's initiative for salvation began with the choice of a people to become a people of the covenant so that heaven and earth could be reunited. This is what we hear about in Genesis chapter 28, about the dream of Jacob. He had a dream and he saw a stairway to heaven. In his dream, earth and heaven were reconnected, and there were angels ascending and descending. And that dream was inviting Jacob to become Israel. They were being invited by the Lord to become the ladder, the stairway, the bridge, the covenant that would reconnect God and humankind, heaven and earth. But in the New Testament, the ladder becomes Jesus Himself, the Son of Man. The heaven part has three intentions. Hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done. The earth part also has three intentions. Give us our daily bread. Forgive us as we forgive. Do not bring us to the test, but deliver us from the evil one. But this two-part prayer contains in its very center the vision of Jesus. If heaven and earth have been disengaged from each other, in Jesus, they become reunited. The summary of this prayer is the part that says, on earth as in heaven. Dito sa lupa, para nasa langit. Ito ang layunin niya. Ang simulan ng langit dito pa sa lupa. Na sa puso ng tao, ang pag-asam sa langit ay magsimula dito sa lupa. Kung makita ng tao ang buhay bilang lakbay, ang dito sa lupa ay parang sa langit. Ang lupa man ay langit na rin. Kapag sinasamba natin ang kanyang ngala, kapag naghahari siya sa atin, kapag sinusunod natin ang kalooban niya, kapag naghahangad tayo ng pagkain pang araw-araw, lalo na yung pagkain galing sa langit, galing sa Diyos, dahil hindi lang nabubuhay ang tao sa tinapay, kundi sa bawat salitang nagmula sa bibig ng Diyos. Ang langit nagsisimula sa ating piling. Pag natuto tayo magpakumbaba, to ask for forgiveness for our sins. But how can we ask for forgiveness for our sins if we cannot be forgiving to our sinners. One always goes with the other. Ang patawad ay hindi lang pagpapakumbaba upang humingi ng tawad higit sa lahat. Ito ay ang kakayahang magpatawad. At ang pag-iwas, pagtakwil kay Satanas sa tukso, sa masama. Ito yung pinag-iimbita ng Panginoon sa atin. I invite you, brothers, as you focus on Jesus, to listen to Jesus, drilling us on His vision. You didn't choose Him, He chose you. He chose you to become His friends, so that in His absence, He can be present in you and through you, because He has chosen you to be His sacrament, His sign and instrument. And He chose each one of us to make holy God's name, to let God's kingdom reign in our midst, to do God's will, and to feed with God's daily bread, to forgive and to ask for forgiveness, and to struggle it out with the evil one, relying only on the strength that comes from the Spirit. And even while we struggle, we hold on to the hope that He has won the victory. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory belongs to Him, forever and ever. Thank you.